Nearly 10 years ago, the Cranberries shot to fame with their debut album, Everybody Else Is Doing It. In 2002, they're still writing and touring, this year playing Monte Carlo, Las Vegas, and Singapore, among many cities. We caught up with Dolores and the band for an intimate portrait of one of the world's greatest modern rock groups. A backstage pass for the Cranberries.
Got together in, was it 1990?
Yeah.
1990, around May. We recorded a couple of demos and sent them off to different record companies, and after about a year we started getting some interest from a load of different record companies. And then we signed to Island Records. We're doing a tour in Europe, and we heard that our single Linger was taken off over here. It was actually a channel in Atlanta. Do you have to, do you have to, do you have to let it linger? Then we went back and recorded our second album and did some more touring. In your head, zombie, 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 yeah, yeah. Did our third album and then did some more touring. And then we kind of, well, ground to a halt because we had worked far too much.
We took a career break for a couple of years and we all started families and stuff. And then we released Bury the Hatchet in 98.
Out, yeah.
And we toured that briefly for about a year. I went back and had another baby and we took a little break again, and then we released this one, which is called Wake Up and Smell the Coffee. Rockers, old rockers, you know. It's like coming around the second time, you know, when you get to that point when you have the greatest hits. I think you're realizing that you are a little bit older, you're not the new kids on the block anymore. I think we're going to call it the Stars, because it's kind of like a joyful moment, and it's a good thing, and it's like stars are just so amazing and up there and whatever. So we've chosen that title, The Stars, and there's a song called The Stars, which we're going to put on it. Tonight, maybe I will wear this because it's shiny and nuts looking. With a pair of biker boots, you see, this is the issue. These, I wear these going on all the time because for a second, the audience think that you've lost the plot and you're gone really bonkers, and I wear it for about one or two songs and then I take it off. Oh, I'm only playing. When you're on stage, you're just a different person to what you are in reality, and, you know, you can get away with it, so why not have fun with it? Come in here with me. This is a case that we've created ages ago. I do my own makeup and all that stuff because I like to keep it real. It's just kind of a calming thing. I don't like lots of people around me when I'm getting ready for a show because it gives me the jitters. And that's a rather old picture of my two bambinos, actually. That's my little girl after she was just born. I usually do yoga for an hour or so before I go on stage, just like so I'm calm. I'm This is my, like, nibblies. It's what I eat before I go on stage. Same crap, usually fruit and stuff like that. Vino rosso, je suis a... Of course, the red wine, I'm only messing. I always definitely need to have honey, like most singers. And I like ginger, I like to eat ginger. This is garlic, I just eat it like that as well. Honestly, I just like sit in hotel rooms and just order bowls of parsley. And they, of course, the room service people think your one from the Cranberries is off her head. She's eating raw parsley. But like, if I eat the garlic, then you have to eat the parsley or else you smell like an Italian. Here's the boys. This is a wardrobe case I had made up for my children, and my band boys stole it. That's basically what the boys do. They play these games all the time before they go on stage. So here's the stage. Oh, lovely, it's outdoors. When the show's starting, I come in here. This is my quick change boot. Come in. It's a bit dark, right? But over here is my potty. See, that's a rock star's potty. Mirror, touch up the makeup, drinks. I have this recurring nightmare about this thing falling down and me being standing here in front of thousands of people. Starkers. This is my guitar tech, lads. It's one of my guitars. Here's more of them. Check it out. So feel free to wander around. Make yourself at home. Would you like a cup of tea? You never really know if you're going to make it. But if we do make it, it would be nice just to be sane and not be in some asylum and not be dependent on anything and have the health and the happiness that we now have, really. Having said that, it would be nice to be still making music and still be kind of going as the Cranberries. But either way, it is very unpredictable. Life is very unpredictable.
Rocking all over the world, the Cranberries.